Hey, what's good, everyone? It's your boy, Mikey Savage 21, aka the Prince of All Sweaties, bringing you another sweaty discussion. And today, I'm going to be talking about the future of the X-Men franchise, pending the Disney Fox deal, as well as giving my thoughts and opinions on the upcoming X-Men movies. Stay tuned. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and enable notifications so you'll never miss out on another sweaty discussion video. Now, without further delay, let's jump into the discussion.
Yeah!
Hey everyone, hope you're having a sweat-tastic day. Today I'm going to be discussing and reacting to the future of the X-Men franchise, pending the Disney Fox deal, and in this video I'm also going to specifically focus on New Mutants and Dark Phoenix, okay? Alright, so let's get into it. Let's talk about New Mutants and Dark Phoenix. So originally both these movies were scheduled to come out this year, 2018. Originally, I think Dark Phoenix was going to come out later in the year, towards November. But of course, now it's been pushed all the way back to February 14, 2019. And then again, you have the same thing being happened to New Mutants, which got pushed back all the way into later 2019. Around that September, August date, I believe. But the funny thing is, why? So first, we're going to look at Screen Rant's article about why X-Men Dark Phoenix release date was delayed 3 months. So it's being reported that Dark Phoenix's delay has been heavily influenced by reshoots in response to test screenings. And due to scheduling conflicts with star Sophie Turner on Game of Thrones, they couldn't take place until summer 2018, necessitating a delay for re-editing and special effects. And according to the article, the New Mutants is also reportedly undergoing reshoots as well. Of course, this wasn't the only major announcement made by Fox regarding the upcoming films. Again, in its place, the Freddie Mercury biopic starring Rami Malek has been moved into its place. And now Dark Phoenix is now scheduled to come out again, like I mentioned, February 14, 2019. Okay, that's the first little piece of news that we had of what was going on. And everybody was wondering, okay, so these movies have been pushed back. Now, why was New Mutants pushed back? Okay, according to sources and other articles, New Mutants was apparently pushed back due to the same thing about test screenings. One story said that they wanted to tone down the horror elements a little bit because they felt like it was too scary and that they were pushing that rated R boundary too hard. Then the other report saying that it was going to be PG-13 and they had to take some of the scariness out of it so they could keep with that PG-13 mentality. Me personally, I'd rather New Mutants be rated R. I know it's going to alienate certain age demographics and everything, but we have seen lately when you let a movie do what it's supposed to do, if it's got a good story and whatnot, but if you have a real good horror story set within a rated R setting, and the same thing could be said with a PG-13 movie, it will make money. I mean, again, I think the biggest factor of this was the It movie. I mean, no one expected It to come out and crush like it did in box office. Again, this is a rated R horror film, and this movie grossed so much money that it even warranted a sequel, and now people are even more hyped up about the sequel. Again, you can say Deadpool did it first, but in terms of the comic book genre and everything. But if you want to talk about a horror movie specifically, I feel like It is the one that really opened up the doors for New Mutants in terms of it being rated R. But again, there was rumors going around that X-Men Dark Phoenix and New Mutants had been canceled. But of course, that isn't the case. And again, according to Screen Rant, which we're getting our source from, directed by longtime X-Men producer Simon Kinberg, Dark Phoenix is the next entry in the main mutant series. It's picking up with the McAvoy Fassbender prequel team in the 1990s for a readaptation of the famed Dark Phoenix saga. And again, I know we don't like to talk about it. Again, they tried this with 2006's X-Men The Last Stand. I'm not going to focus heavily on that movie. A lot of people were getting that same kind of vibe of the 2006 movie in the test screenings from the original showing of Dark Phoenix earlier this year, which is one of the reasons why audiences didn't like it so much is why they did reshoots. Now, again, you could say reshoots are always been scheduled in the movies. Reshoots are just a part of making a movie. Anytime someone's going in for pickup or reshoots, it's not necessarily a bad thing. They already have these scheduled ahead of time. When it gets kind of nervous is when it gets closer to the film and they go in and start doing reshoots or you hear they're doing reshoots because they're trying to take certain things out or trying to add certain things in at the last minute. Now, again, sometimes this works, sometimes it doesn't. When the case of Dark Phoenix, apparently when it's so CGI heavy with so many effects, if you're trying to redo half of your movie, that's going to take a little bit more time because you don't want to just put a movie out there and have bad graphics. Again, with the flop that was Justice League last year, I'm sure Joss Whedon would have loved to have had more time to work on the overall effects and everything for the Justice League movie, because that was one of the factors that everyone hated that movie, was because of how bad it looked in terms of Steppenwolf. Again, the whole controversy with Henry Cavill's mustache of Superman and everything. If that would have had more time, they probably would have been able to fix it. And this could be the same case with Dark Phoenix. Then for a little while, we all simply thought, okay, maybe we're going to get something at Comic-Con from Fox. Maybe they're going to drop like another teaser trailer for New Mutants, or finally a full trailer. Maybe we're going to see a teaser for X-Men Dark Phoenix. But instead, we didn't get anything, which is so weird. Because again, Marvel wasn't having a big presence. Disney said that they were not bringing any form of a panel this year. The floor was open for Fox to come in and drop some stuff, and of course for DC to come in and drop some stuff. DC absolutely crushed it, and just Warner Brothers in general, they crushed it. Universal, they also came to play, but I feel like Warner Brothers, in terms of San Diego Comic-Con 2018, they won. Warner Brothers definitely won. But this was an opportunity for Fox to come in and show us something from New Mutants or something from X-Men Dark Phoenix. Because even if you're having to go back and heavily reshoot both New Mutants and Dark Phoenix, you still already have pieces of your movie done. I mean, all we've gotten so far from New Mutants is a teaser. We haven't gotten anything from Dark Phoenix. So you think they would have showed up to Comic-Con prepared with something, yet it's been dark. And so for all these months, people have been speculating, saying that, okay, maybe it's just quietly being pushed into the background. It's going to be canceled pending this Disney Fox deal. Now, again, I said I was going to talk about the Disney Fox deal again that has not gone through yet. And they said that that could still take a little while. So for people who are wanting to see X-Men pop up in Avengers 4, that's not going to happen. I do not think that's going to happen. I do not see them even doing a post-credit scene, because the deal has not gone through yet. And if anything is to believe, like what's going on with Time Warner right now, and Time Warner and AT&T, you see the government just stepped in. So this could also throw a little bit of a monkey wrench into the deal with Disney and Fox, even though the shareholders have already approved the deal. Anything could happen within these couple of months. But again, nothing from Dark Phoenix, nothing from New Mutants. So everyone just assumed, okay, well, maybe it's got canceled. Maybe it's quietly being pushed into the back. Nobody's going to talk about it or anything. However, as of a week ago, X-Men Dark Phoenix and New Mutants both were confirmed for 2019 by IMAX. Again, IMAX released its quarterly earnings report, providing investors with the upcoming slate of movies, and this 2019 forecast has X-Men Dark Phoenix and the New Mutants included in their respective release dates. So again, in my terms, the reason I think, again, they pushed these movies back besides to work on the overall story is they also wanted to kind of space this out. Because look, if Disney does take over Fox, well, who's to say that Disney would even release these two types of films? They might not want to release them. They might look at them and say, we don't think these films are going to be any good, or they're not going to further the story that we want to have to tell with these characters, because we're essentially going to reboot anyway if Disney decides to reboot. So what Fox is doing is they're spreading their movies out, because let's just say they did have New Mutants come out. Well, first of all, it was going to have to go against Black Panther in February, where it originally was. And we all know Black Panther is just a behemoth of a movie. Now, again, you could say Black Panther, they're going for the same audiences, but one would be rated R or PG-13, depending on what they ended up deciding to do with the rating for the movie. You would have it going against Black Panther. I would have to say Black Panther would be the one to topple New Mutants. Again, New Mutants is an interesting concept. It's something that we've never seen before. It was going to have to go up against Black Panther, and it didn't want to do that. And then again, for Dark Phoenix, if it wasn't testing well, which again, test screenings are subjective, because it might work for some and it might not work for others. And I guess they were just a little bit worried that, okay, if the majority of our test screeners are saying that they don't like this, that they're getting those 2006 X-Men Last Stand vibes, maybe we should do something with this movie. But again, if IMAX is reporting that these movies are definitely going to be coming out on their scheduled dates. That means, again, we're getting Dark Phoenix in February. I would say we would probably get a trailer maybe, I don't know, maybe somewhere in October, maybe. I would think New Mutants would definitely try to drop a trailer in October since it's Halloween, and that's when you have a lot of scary movies coming out. Again, with the new Halloween film, and then you have Venom coming out. That's a chance for them to actually promote New Mutants and Dark Phoenix respectively, because Dark Phoenix can actually be quite of a scary story if you go through and read the comic book about what all happens with Jean Grey and the X-Men respectively. But I kind of got on a little bit of a side tangent here. What I was saying before was the reason I think that Fox moved these movies ultimately because they needed to work on the story and everything and then effects and blah, 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 all that good stuff is because they wanted to scatter them out. Originally, Fox had Deadpool 2 coming out. Then you had New Mutants also coming out. And you also had Dark Phoenix coming out. Then on top of that, you know, we already had other superhero films coming out. Like you had Black Panther coming out. You had Avengers Infinity War coming out. You had Ant-Man and the Wasp coming out. We have Venom coming out. We have Aquaman coming out. You have all these superhero films coming out. And again, I don't think we're in that state of superhero fatigue, but you have a lot of superhero films coming out that were so far pretty amazing. All the ones we've seen so far were pretty amazing. So you have to live up to their expectations, because again, Dark Phoenix is in a little bit of hot water right now because X-Men Apocalypse was just a pile of garbage. It was not that great, especially compared to the other two movies of First Class and of Days of Future Past. Those movies were brilliant, especially Days of Future Past. And then when you get to X-Men Apocalypse, not only did you waste the character of Apocalypse, but you're already teasing the Dark Phoenix already towards the end of the movie. Spoiler alert for those of you who have not seen X-Men Apocalypse. But again, that movie left a very sour taste in people's mouth. So then when they hear test screenings that Dark Phoenix isn't doing so well, that's when they're like, okay, maybe we need to go back and we need to retool everything, maybe take a look at the story, maybe redo some of these effects and everything. But again, I think the main reason that the X-Men, Dark Phoenix, and New Mutants is they wanted to kind of separate themselves. They want to kind of put themselves on a further slate. That way, they're able to kind of get away from all this competition, but also take time to work on their stories and whatnot. Now, in terms of this Disney Marvel Fox deal for the future of the franchise, I can see it going one of two ways, okay? If the deal does go through, this is possibility one. If the deal does go through and Disney does acquire Fox and all of its assets and whatnot, and they get control back of the X-Men, the Fantastic Four, Deadpool, all of that, here's one thing that they could do. If X-Men Dark Phoenix is good, they can incorporate that in there somehow. Maybe this is something, again, this movie is supposed to be set in the 90s, so this would be taking place before the first Iron Man movie. So maybe you could say that during this saga, the majority of the X-Men were wiped out because of what was going on with the Dark Phoenix saga, or maybe some of them were in hiding and whatnot. Because these films take place in the past, so you could say they're in the MCU, but they're in the past MCU before the current one that we have now. We'll have to see again how Captain Marvel does it and before Iron Man and the rest of these films were to take place. All right, so you have that possibility going. Now, in terms of New Mutants, you can stick New Mutants anywhere because you could just say after the effects of Avengers 3 and 4, maybe scientists have decided, okay, we have this threat named Thanos. Come down, snap his fingers, wipe out half the population. We need to get a hold of set of people who can defend us from people like this in case the Avengers aren't able to. So that's when the whole New Mutants concept comes in, where you take these humans and you start doing experiments on them, and then you start messing with their mutagens and whatnot, and they start mutating. New Mutants, again, could fit kind of anywhere, especially after Avengers 3 or 4 somewhere. But again, Dark Phoenix, that takes place in the past, so you'd have to explain if you wanted to use the same characters in the MCU, just, I guess, more older adult versions of them, which, again, you'd have to age them up with technology and what's not, which I don't really see them doing, but if they wanted to go that route, they could. Here's possibility number two, which is the most likely one. X-Men Dark Phoenix is going to come out, whether it's good or whether it's bad, has no bearing on the MCU. Same thing with New Mutants, has no bearing on the MCU. And they're going to take these characters and they're going to reboot them and retool them again. and just do a completely different story. We're not going to do a younger version of Professor X or for Magneto. You're just going to have the older characters that kind of match up with the Avengers timeline and everything of how old they look, because they've been doing this for several years now. Again, New Mutants is the only one that could kind of, I could see maybe not recasting for, especially if it's really good and it's a hit and it's a success in the movies. And again, in Marvel's not dumb. They're not dumb. If they see that a movie made a ton of money, they're going to try to capitalize on that. And again, if Dark Phoenix comes out and it's a pile of crap, they're going to try to get as far away from the X-Men and reboot it as possible. So again, those are the likely scenarios I see for Dark Phoenix and, of course, New Mutants. One scenario, one, Dark Phoenix takes place in the past, and then you age up the characters and slowly try to integrate them into the current MCU that you have without recasting or anything. Scenario 2, it's set to where X-Men Dark Phoenix comes out, does whatever it does, it has no bearing on the MCU. You take those characters, retool them, and then integrate them slowly into the MCU. I lean more towards the second one. And again, in terms of New Mutants, I still think whether Dark Phoenix flops or not in February, whether it's not a good movie that has no bearing on New Mutants whatsoever, because if that movie comes out and it crushes, it can still be integrated into the MCU because they have not given us a timeline for New Mutants. But either way, I'm kind of excited to see what's going to be the future of the X-Men franchise. Again, the franchise itself has suffered its ups and its downs, because again, when those first two films came out, everybody was in love with them. Then the third one came and just nosedived. Then we ended up getting Wolverine X-Men Origins. That nosedived. Then we got the Wolverine, which kind of had people a little hyped. And then you got the reboot series that we currently have going on. Everyone was a little hyped about First Class. And Days of Future Past came out and people were just going absolutely crazy. Then you had Apocalypse happen and it kind of took a nosedive again. Then you have Logan come out and oh, it's all the way back up again. And then if you want to throw Deadpool in there, you also have Deadpool, what was on a rise. Then Deadpool 2 kept pushing it up and pushing it up further and further. It set the bar so high that now Dark Phoenix and New Mutants have a pretty high bar to reach. Again, not comparing it to what Sony is doing or what Marvel at Disney is doing, but in terms of what Deadpool 2, and Logan have done, and X-Men Days of Future Past and X-Men First Class, they have set the bar really high. So either it can go the route of X-Men Apocalypse and ultimately just crash and burn, or ultimately it's going to raise the stakes. Either way, I'm excited to see both of these films, and I'm kind of excited to see what the future of this franchise is going to be like, because I think Disney is ultimately going to treat these characters right. Not to say that Fox hasn't, but I think Disney is going to be even more careful about these characters, and they're going to make sure they dish them out slowly but surely. They're not going to throw all of them at us at once. And in terms of what Fox will necessarily do with them if the Disney deal doesn't go through, I guess they'll just continue forward as business. Whether New Mutants again is good or whether Dark Phoenix is good, they'll just keep trying to make more X-Men films. So it looks like in the end, Disney buying Fox out probably would be better for the X-Men franchise, because again, if those two movies flop, then I think it's time for some fresh eyes to come in there with those characters and kind of retool and reboot them and get them to the level of excellence that we know that they can be at. But again, guys, you have heard my thoughts on the future of the X-Men franchise, but the discussion doesn't stop there. Let me know down in the comment section below what you think about these movies that I've talked about. Are you excited for New Mutants? Are you excited for Dark Phoenix and the possibility of future installments? What are your thoughts on the other films being erased from this timeline once the Disney Fox deal is final, depending on which scenario they decide to go with? Post your thoughts down below and be sure to subscribe to my channel to hear more sweaty discussions like this. Thank you as always for tuning in, and I hope you all have a fantastic day. Peace out, y'all.